Today I'm going to show you guys how to install this Bluetooth aux adapter I'm going to start selling. I got a lot of requests for me to make something like this, especially now that the new iPhone 7 doesn't have an aux jack. This will allow you to stream audio via Bluetooth from your phone to your car. It's really easy to install. It's just like installing my aux cable, except we're going to have to tap into a power wire and a ground wire. All that's required is if you have have the car coded for aux. If you don't have it, watch my other videos how to do it. If you do, just go ahead and you can just plug this right in. It's going to help a lot because right now for the iPhone 7, there's no aux jack, so you're going to have to get an adapter. And if you want to charge it, you got to get one adapter to another adapter. This will just eliminate the aux cord altogether, so you don't have to have it no more. You can just have it nice and clean like this. So I'm going to go ahead and install it. Okay, now to connect the Bluetooth adapter, I already have it pre-connected, but I'm going to show you where I connected it to. To get to the point where you have to take off all the panels, check out my other videos. I have exactly step-by-step how to take off all the panels here. It's really easy. Okay, so once you get to this point, we're going to have to tap into the harness behind the radio, which will be this harness. To take it off, you just hold this lever down right here, and it pops out like this. And then when you put it back on, it locks in place. It's locked on, so lifting it up makes it come off. Okay, the wires we're going to be tapping into are just two wires. Obviously, the power wire and a ground wire. The power wire, we're going to be tapping into the accessory wires so that you only get power when the vehicle is on. Obviously you don't want it on all the time, just when the vehicle's on. It's going to be wire number 13 in this harness right here. 13, which is this wire right here. It's a white and violet wire. Right here. See if I can get up close to. It's white and violet. So we'll tap into it. The way I tapped into it is I tapped into it using these type of connectors, so I can always let's say I want to unplug this and plug it back in. You don't have to use this type of connector. You could use this kind too. Let me see, I have one here. This kind right here. The way this one works is it lets you put a wire in this slot. And then the other wire here, so you don't have to cut anything. It goes in between, like for example, if I wanted to tap into this wire right here, it goes like this. And then the other wire that's going to get tapped through, for instance, this wire, will go on this side. So you can use this. There's different options. I use these kind just in case I ever want to unplug this so I can plug something else for power. I can always just do that. Any route is fine. This video is just showing you which wires to tap into. So like I said, the first one, the power wire, which mine is red, is going to be tapped into this white and neon and white and violet color. It's like a purple, violet, and white, number 13 behind this harness right here. It has like this blue thing that keeps it locked in place. Okay, and then the ground wire is a thicker wire. So I use a thicker gauge connector, which is the blue one. And this is an all brown wire. This is all solid brown. And this is in slot number 12 right here. So in the same little connector here from the very bottom corner, number 12, you're gonna tap into the brown wire. All right, so that's gonna take care of the power part of this cable. Now, then you have to connect to the harness, which is right here. No, I already had it taken out, but let me put it back in so I can show you guys how I got it out. So we're gonna tap into this one. A lot of people always email me saying which is the correct one. It's gonna be underneath your fiber optic cables. So see these green wires? It's gonna be directly underneath it. So to the opposite of where we just connected the power and ground, the opposite corner, this one right here. To take this out, there's a little lever here. Press it down and you slide it up. I had this covered in my other videos, but just so we can get full how-to on this one. Okay, and this one, to take this thing out, we're going to have to slide this out. And it slides out. You pinch this little locking thing up, and then this slides out. Okay, so now we're going to plug the aux cable. I have it plugged in already, because I want to show you guys in case you have another aux cable already plugged in, how to take the old one out. So, it's really easy. Let's say it's this one right here. The center one right here, this little number 2 for the white one. You can get a paper clip, and you see these little windows right here, they're locked in place. So what we gotta do is just press it down, and then this slides out. So if you need to take one old one out, just use a paper clip, press it in. You don't want to just yank it out because it's locked in. You might rip it out and then you'll have this stuck. If it does get stuck, you could always just, using two paper clips, use press one down and then stick the other one in there to slide it out. So it'll be better and a lot of time saved if you do it the right way, which press it down and then slide it out. Because what you want to do is you want to press down this little locking thing here, this little triangle. Press that thing down and it'll go down and let you slide it out. So once that's all in, connect it all back. And then I make these kind of a little bit long so you can tuck it back there. So when you put it all back in, nothing's in the way. And then you just gotta connect it back. There, just put everything back together and then I'm gonna show you guys how to connect it and it working. Okay, now that we got it installed, we're gonna go ahead and pair this to the Bluetooth device.
Paired.
You heard that how it said paired? You will hear that when it pairs up to it. I have already pre-paired it. But like any phone, you just have to go to your settings and then you go to your Bluetooth and you'll find it. For instance, this one's called Yet M1. I'll show you if it comes with a different name. If I sell you one, I'll write in the instructions and the passcode is always going to be 000. So just read the instructions. If not, as you can see here, it's already been connected. So once it's connected, you just go to like your regular aux menu on your iDrive. And then you're ready to go. Just put on some music. I'll put on Pandora here just to test it out. Let's say you want to just switch it out. Here's your menus. So now it's playing from the phone. It still has good CD quality.
Hey, Jet Setter. New York is the city for insiders, and that's exactly how you'll feel.
So now it's complete, just Bluetooth. You don't have to worry about an aux cable no more. And then you can see the install wasn't that hard, quality is good. And now you can plug your phone, charge it, and you have to worry about another cable if you have the iPhone 7. I want to thank everyone for subscribing and watching all my videos. Any questions, comments, please ask below in the comment section. Email me, visit my website, roskinc.com. I made an Instagram page, roskincbmw. It's my Instagram page. Ask any questions, email me. Thanks a lot for subscribing and watching my videos.